coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. Warrior fields it at the 17. He's tackled at the 28. The Golden Eagles have shown over the course of the season that they want to get this guy the football, but you can't just go to him every play.
Well, on the road, you especially want to take the crowd out of the game, and the one guy you know who can do it is this wide receiver. The problem you have is this defense, more often than not, is going to be aligned to take him out of the game. And that, to your point, Brad, that's where somebody's going to have to step up, whether it's the running game, some of the other receivers. You're going to have to take some of the pressure off of him and really make it a team effort to be able to win this game on the road.
So it's 2nd and 12. Ball on the 26. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. Bring up a punting situation.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
Dion to punt. Tackle at the 30-yard line.
Well, the coverage team did their job and made the play. Let's see if the defense can continue the effort.
Really questionable decision to field the ball there. Tough to get traction or even maintain your grip on the ball. That could have turned out even worse than it did.
Nice run, and he's brought down. That brings him 2nd and 5. 2nd and 5. Ball on their own 35. Down at the 47.
Just a simple draw play there, but they picked up some big yards.
And he tackles him hard at the 35.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
From the 35-yard line, first down. They'll run it. Runs it right. Nice pickup.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. Inside the 10. Touchdown! Huge play!
Wow! When you see that end zone in front of you, it can elevate your running to another level. Awesome play!
Splits the uprights with the extra point. A 5-play, 71-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, not only did they put points up on the board, but I think it's the way they did it. That could be demoralizing for defense.
The score now, 7-0. White fields it at the 11, and he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. The Hurricanes are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change. middle for a nice game. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. And he's tackled around the 27-yard line.
Well, the question now is, how will they respond after losing a couple on that run?
The 32-yard line.
Brad, you can really feel and sense the energy coming from the sidelines right now. They know how important it is to pick up first downs, and the coaches right now are showing the excitement that they have and yelling out the next play for the offense. But clearly, the offensive coordinator very happy about the execution.
Brought down at the 32. From their own 32-yard line. Second down. He's wrapped up for the sack.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. Dia is the punter. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
He's at the 30. He's at the 20. To the 10. Touchdown! The halfback got the carry and through that defense for a score.
He found some daylight and took off for six.
And he tacks on the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. White takes it at the 14. He makes it to the 25-yard line. The Hurricanes really came prepared to play defense today, and the plan is working.
Well, so far in this game, you've got to tip your cap to the defensive coordinator. He has clearly done a very good job of getting his team ready to play, and they have done a nice job of slowing down this very explosive offense.
It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one. So the halfback loses about two on the run. From their own 23-yard line. Second down. And they make the stop around the 20-yard line.
That play was over before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
Lays it out there. The defender had it and then dropped it.
Johnson's intended receiver on the play. That brings us fourth and 15.
Dia is waiting for the snap. He really got a hold of that one. And down he goes at the 49. The Hurricanes have been waiting for a game like this, and their offensive coordinator has been praying for one, and I think his prayers are answered so far early.
Well, he put together a great game plan. He talked with you and I about how he felt like they could exploit some things, and they've done it up to this point. See if they can maintain it and continue to play well.
He's tackled right around the 48-yard line. We've played one. The Hurricanes in front, 14-0. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. And he is drilled at the 41-yard line. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Nice gain as he works to the right side.
Smart call here to trust your line and the ball carrier to gain the yards they had to for the first down.
Taken down at the 25-yard line. From the 25-yard line, it's first down. A 2-yard run by the halfback.
Good stop there by the freshman. You got to be careful with this offensive attack because one missed tackle could mean trouble.
Around the 26-yard line.
Call it a loss of 3 yards on the play. That brings up third and 12.
And once again, they'll come to the line, try to convert on third down. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Quick strike to the receiver. And down he goes at the 13. You know, this is just amazing. You spend 6 days planning as a defensive coordinator for one guy, and then you get the other quarterback. So now what happens? This is the eighth play of this drive. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Ball inside the 10-yard line. It's second down. And he's got the touchdown.
That's a positive for the passing game. It was absolutely the right call in that situation.
And he adds the extra point. A 9-play, 50-yard drive. And they put up 7 points. Looks like they're ready for the kick. White takes it at the 12. Tackle made at the 25. Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. And they got him for a loss.
Did you see how that big defensive line got such a good push on that play? That's exactly why they were able to stop him for a loss.
Second down and 14. Ball on the 22-yard line. 7 for a loss.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking schemes. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
There's a strike complete. Tackle made at the 37.
It's a smart job here by the coaches, making a play call here that really played to their offensive strengths. That's knowing your personnel.
From their own 37-yard line, first down. After a decent pickup, Clark gains about 5 yards on the run.
That brings him second and five.
Golden Eagles taking their first time out of the half. That's a great tackle at the 35-yard line.
That makes it third and 11.
So we're looking at another third down here. It's knocked away, incomplete.
If you can get a hand up at the line of scrimmage on every pass, you'll really make it tough on a quarterback to find his rhythm back in the pocket.
Dion awaits the snap. And this one is a beauty. Room around the corner. He's out to the 30. Gets to about the 37-yard line.
The Hurricanes are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. They'll bring him down around the 48-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. He's got it out to his tight end. And he's immediately tackled. Receiver again. He gets hit out of bounds.
Right around the 32-yard line.
It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Slings it out there incomplete.
That would have been pretty remarkable if he'd managed to hold on to the ball after taking a shot like that.
He's going to come up short. Good tackle.
That'll make it fourth and two.
It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it.
Three down, three down. 30, what's the mic? Get up. Get down.
Outside for a nice game.
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their schemes.
From the 28-yard line, first down. Defense goes with the extra defensive backs as the offense comes up five wide. Fires it out. Steps out of bounds at the 17. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Got his man. Oh, what a hit.
He made a good read here to find his teammate. That's sound decision making.
The field goal unit's out on the field, and they're going to try to get these guys 3 points before halftime. Kicks away, and it splits the uprights. With only a few ticks left on the clock before halftime, I would expect they'll just squib kick this one. White takes it at the 14. He's taken down at the 23-yard line. First half comes to a close as they head to the locker rooms. The Hurricanes with a 24-point lead.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that the football was so important they named the game after it. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of that.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. And you can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But, you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers, but at the same time taking care of the pigskin. And they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio with the best seat in the house. Belongs to Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down to the end zone for a touchback.
They're not only the better football team on paper, as they've demonstrated today, they're the better team on the field today. And this offense has been outstanding.
It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Run and he's brought down. That'll make it second. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. And he shoved out of bounds at the 41. The 48. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. A quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Pitches it. He's got the corner. He makes it out to midfield. Taken down at about the 47-yard line. That makes it fourth and four. White is the deep man awaiting the return. Booming kick. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Gets it out quickly to the back, but he can't haul it in. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 20. Would have been a big play by the defense. He can't hold it.
This is a very well-coached defense. They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes. This quarterback is tough as nails. Brad, he's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure, or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. He's got it with room to run, and he's tackled at the 31. That makes it first and 10. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 31. Get him for a loss.
The thing about the option is you're going to have some negative play, but if you keep running it, it'll create some big play opportunities.
Stop your whining. 31's the mic.
He makes the catch and has a first down. Brought down at about the 15-yard line. From the 15-yard line, it's first down. They get in, touchdown.
He just put his eyes on that end zone and ran with some real purpose there.
He makes the PAT. So a four-play, 53-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. The score now, 31 to nothing. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. Brought down at the 22. The Hurricanes continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
Not a whole lot's been working for them so far. They should just come out and play loose and easy because they've got nothing to lose. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
From their own 22-yard line, second down. He's on the run. And they get the sack, and they got him with a blitz.
Yeah, that time the pressure came from the safety position. Nobody picked him up, but he came up with a big-time play.
Stop at the 20.
Man, the defense jumped all over that one. No chance to pick up the first down there.
Dion is waiting for the snap. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He's at the 40, and he's taken down at the 31-yard line.
Well, they had a lot of success in their last possession, and now they're going to start this one off with excellent field position.
It's hard to ask your defense to come out and make a stop when they're already backed up this far within their own end zone.
And he hits him hard at the 25-yard line. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five-receiver look. Tackled for a loss.
Loss of 4. That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
He's going to try and scramble, and he's going to come up with a sack.
Loss of 8 yards on the play. That brings us 4th and 15.
They call on the kicker for a long field goal. This will just add insult to injury. The kick is up, and he got it. Like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Golden Eagles have just gone ice cold on offense. They can't seem to get anything going.
And right now, they just have to forget the score, forget the clock, just go out there and try to get a first down, try to hope to build a little bit more confidence and continuity on this offense.
Under heavy pressure. Slides down to the ground. Second and 8 coming up here. Ball on their own 27. And he carries the ball for a nice game. Barring a miracle in the fourth quarter, this one's academic. The Hurricanes in front, 34-0. Just about set to start the fourth quarter, mercifully. A big stop here early in the fourth quarter. They needed some of that earlier because this game is still out of hand.
That'll make it 4th and 6.
Dion to punt. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. And he just got stood up right there. Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. On the ground, right side. Nice run there.
That's a D4 run play. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
Second down and 7 coming up here. Ball on their own 41. Throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
First and 10. Ball on the 40-yard line. slings it. He's taken down at the 33-yard line. Him hard at the 16.
That makes it second and six.
Push out of bounds, setting up a first and goal. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Just under three to go in regulation. Tailback. Touchdown.
Boy, did he look determined running the football. Nobody was going to keep him out of the end zone.
And he hits the PAT. So that's a 7-play, 62-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The deficit is huge, but as a player, you never want to slow down your effort. Believe me, coaches notice the ones who aren't trying that hard. Complete. He's got room.
It really wasn't badly played by the defense, but sometimes a good throw and catch just beats you.
From their own 30-yard line, second down.
Roger, Roger. Mike four, Mike four. Let's go.
Got it to his man on the screen, and down he goes at the 40-yard line.
Call it a gain of 10 yards. First down.
Mike four, doubles, doubles, doubles.
Just under 2 minutes in the game. Made at the 46-yard line.
Number 30 with the tackle.
From the 46-yard line. First down.
Four down, four down. Mike four, Mike four. Set, Omaha, Omaha. Russell, Russell,
they'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
Field.
The defense was able to get really good penetration and drop short of the line of scrimmage.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 36.
Four down, four down. Mike four.
Well, a nice
stop there late in the fourth quarter, but it's a blowout and has been for most of the game. I think it's time for everybody to go home. Deion awaits the snap. Oh, excellent punt. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Hurricanes just put on a clinic in this football game. Right?
You can say that again, Brad. In every phase, the defense has been outstanding. The special teams have been solid. And how about this offense and the way they've executed? It's allowed them to build up a very big lead.
And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
And they finally knock him out at the 35. He's been unstoppable today, 200 yards rushing.
He's had some big holes to run through today. And when you get that kind of space, good things are going to happen.
Let's see now how the defense responds to giving up the gain on the run. Right around the 32-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
Golden Eagles, I'm sure, are secure in the knowledge that despite this setback today, they still have one of the best players in the country.
Well, this is a devastating loss, but it's one that they're going to have to put behind them. And as you said, they still have one of the best players in the country. They don't need to deviate their plan. Get back to really what they know, and that's getting the ball to their star player. And next week, I'm sure they'll be fine.
Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.